Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In last week's episode, we talked about QString, Qlatin one string, QString literal, QString whatever. And this episode will continue our quest down on understanding Qt and its affection for string. We'll talk about a class called QStringBuilder. And today with me to understand that, well, for me to understand much better, I have Pepe De Angelo or Giuseppe or however you want to pronounce his name. welcome, Pepe.
Hi, yes, sir.
I had a code review, as everything in these episodes is hoovering around. I had a code review where one of my coworkers were pointing out that I should be using a percentage instead of plus when I was concatenating strings. And trust me, concatenate strings plus percentage is not an easy target to Google. But eventually I accepted that I had no clue what he was talking about. And he said, well, string builder, of course. So I thought, okay, I'll go into Qt Creator and I pressed question mark QString builder. And what I got to was the animation framework of QML, which is like, okay. But finally I found something on QStringBuilder. But could you just remind our viewers in 1 minute, what is QStringBuilder?
Right. So suppose that you want to concatenate, let's say two or more strings. Okay. Mm-hmm. Clearly QString defines an operator plus that allows you to do that. So if you write A plus B plus C, well, those are strings, you get a string, which is the result of the concatenation. In Qt, you can also do the same thing by writing A percentage B percentage C. So you're going to use a slightly different operator, a percentage, rather than plus, again, for performing the concatenation. The difference is how this concatenation is performed exactly. In the first case, it's performed in a somehow naive way. That is, if you're concatenating A, B, and C, the first thing you're going to do is concatenate A and B. So you're going to build a string, which is the result of concatenation of A and B. And then when you do that plus C, you're going to build yet another string, which is the result of the first temporary concatenation of A and B. And then you append C to that. And if you can keep going, you start noticing that along the way, you're building a lot of temporary strings for storing the partial results of this concatenation. What does the percentage do? Or what does this class QStringBuilder do? Well, the percentage tells Qt to use a helper class behind the scenes. This helper class is called QStringBuilder. It's an invisible class to you, that is, you never spell it out yourself. It's just the implementation of the percentage operator. And what that class does is that it tries to do the same concatenation in a slightly smarter way. That is, instead of doing A plus B, temporary, then plus C, another temporary, plus D, another temporary. What it does is actually building a little object in which it just keeps track of the strings to concatenate. So it's like a little notebook in which it says, okay, you want me to concatenate A plus B? Okay. Oh, and also plus C? Okay. And also plus D? Okay. And it doesn't do anything at that point until, let's say, it reaches the end of everything you want to concatenate. So once it's got everything, then it will do the concatenation. And since it remembers everything that it needs to concatenate, it can actually just build one string, the final one, the final result, consisting of all the other strings that it needs to concatenate together. Okay.
So it's
just, from this point of view, it's just a somehow significant performance improvement because, you know, having all these tiny bit allocations all over our source code is one of the things that annoys a little bit because it's one of those things that will never appear in a profiler and so on. Because if you do a temporary allocation and you do it in 100,000 different places, a profiler will never pinpoint that out to you. But it's still 100,000 temporary allocations that you could get rid of by switching to this way of concatenating strings, percentages and not plus.
So I Googled a bit on and I found a document on QStringBuilder that from the design time of it, there's a link up here for it. And it's actually pretty straightforward. Actually, there is an improvement to adding the percent sign in 100,000 different places, so how many you mentioned there. Namely, to just turn it on throughout your whole application. There is a macro called QStringBuilder, and you do like this in your profile, and you do like this in your CMake file. And Pippa's just like, what? Where?
What? Anyway,
it is not on by default. Why is that?
Yeah, it is not on by default because, of course, that's the question that comes into mind. Like, wait a minute, if you got a better way of doing the concatenation, why is the concatenation doing that out of the box? All right. So why is this entire mechanism opt-in, either case by case by using a percentage or globally by using by defining this macro before including Qt headers? The reason why it's not turned on by default is because it's got at least a couple of subtle incompatibilities. Mm. Or not so subtle incompatibilities. Well, one is kind of visible. There could be some cases in which if you enable this, your code stops compiling. Okay, this is generally speaking, it happens when you do have some sort of, for instance, implicit conversions from string to something else. And now that string was the result of concatenating multiple things together. So before, when you used operator plus, the old one, that result was already a Q string, and this enabled the conversion to, say, Q variant. Okay, that's something you can build implicitly from a Q string. Mm-hmm. Now, if you do enable the string builder, the result of that concatenation is not a Q string directly, it's a Q string builder. And that one does not convert implicitly to qvariant anymore or to anything else. So that code will stop compiling. You will need to go there and fix it. And the fix is trivial. It's nothing but just, you know, add the cast to qstring or save the result in a temporary qstring and then build a variant out of it. So it's a really minuscule amount of refactoring. So nothing of concern. But there is a second one, and the second one is actually a bit more subtle and a little bit more dangerous, which is this. If you build a string by concatenating things together, and you use string builder in order to do so, and you take that result of the concatenation and you store it in a variable that you of which you don't declare the type explicitly, okay, of which for which you're using auto type deduction. So you write something auto result equal A plus B plus C, just to say an example before. What's the type of result? You would expect, okay, that's clearly concatenating strings. It must be a string. But what we have just said is that that's not the type of that expression anymore once you enable the string builder. The type of that expression is now string builder. Okay. Mm. And this is kind of a danger because what String Builder really does, as I mentioned, is it takes its little notebook and just writes down, okay, I need to concatenate that, that, and that. It doesn't do the actual concatenation until you tell it to do so. And by having the ability of storing a String Builder into, say, an auto variable, opens the door for a possible mistake there. That is, for instance, you build that variable that like that, and then you manipulate or destroy one of the original strings, and then you finalize the conversion. Now, that little notebook that the string builder had in hand is referencing a destroyed string. And so soon enough, when you run this code, your code will crash.
I tried that this morning and it crashed, and I was like, yeah. Pepe just got me in trouble again. I will get to him in today's episode of Qt Widgets and More, where I will be. And your answer to that was?
My answer to that was that don't worry too much about that, because there are warnings that the compilers can give you regarding this. So this situation that I just described really happens due to this unfortunate interaction between auto type deduction and QString Builder. There is, by the way, another one which is very, very similar, that is, for instance, inside a lambda function. If you have a lambda which returns A plus B plus C, okay, if you are a C++ guru, ask yourself this question. That is, what is the return type of the function call operator of the closure of the lambda? Okay, the lambda defines a little struct, a little closure with a function call operator inside. What's the return type? And the answer to that is auto, once more. Okay. If you don't say anything, the compiler is going to reduce that. And again, same interaction. Auto, QString Builder, they don't go hand in hand. But as I said, we have warnings from compilers. Well, not exactly from compilers, but from linting tools.
To say, when you say compilers, don't you mean clazy?
I mean clazy, exactly. I mean linter tooling, like clazy. Clazy has a specific warning that will warn you in either case whether you're whether you're storing a QString Builder into a auto variable, or when you're returning a QString Builder out of a function declared with auto. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. And we tell you change that. Okay, get rid of the auto and put QString explicitly, so that forces the conversion from QString Builder into QString, and that will force the concatenation to happen right there, and this will solve the problem. So I would say, sure, if you enable QString Builder globally, you risk source code breakages, but those are easy to fix. But you risk these runtime crashes, for which an ordinary compiler won't tell you anything. The moment you do that, enable also please run clazy on your source code before committing anything, and check all these warnings, fix these warnings, and then you're good to go. Qt has been built with Qt String Builder enabled since Qt 4 dot something. So for a very, very long time, the entirety of the Qt source code is under that magic macro.
Okay.
So it is absolutely production ready, and I would say you should use it as well.
Okay, that's a relief to hear. Thank you for watching yet another episode of Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, we watched a QString Builder class, and I urge you all to try it out when you get back to your computer and your projects. And do remember to turn on clazy so you don't get in the same problem as me. Good news, if you don't know what clazy is, there are Qt Widgets and More episode on that, so there's links just below on that. And just to get a bit of my honor back, I do have clazy on in my project and in CI. And CI did complain, but before I got to read the complaint from CI, that was when I complained to Pepe about QString Builder. So Pepe, here's your chance on public TV, I was almost about to say, to tell me off.
I told you so, Jesper. That's my time.
Thank you very much. And until next time, I wish you all a great time. Thank you very much for joining me again, Pepe.
Cheers. Bye.